The US Navy has launched an advanced, long-range, all-weather bomb for the first time from an FA-18E&F Super Hornet. Stormbreaker, formerly the Small Diameter Bomb 2 or GBU-53B, had entered the operational test and evaluation phase late last year. Developmental testing and the government confidence testing of Stormbreaker was completed earlier last year. The weapon had achieved a 90% success rate during developmental testing. Viewers may note that Stormbreaker will be integrated into the F-35 also. The bomb will provide a new precision strike option for carrier-launched fighters. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Stormbreaker will be a lethal boost to US Navy supercarriers against China. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. China had big plans for its aircraft carrier program, and there is intense pride associated with it. Chinese political leaders, as well as military planners, wanted to slowly equal the US when it comes to aircraft carriers. But this doesn't seem to be going as per plan. On November 28th, Minnie Chan of the South China Morning Post reported that Beijing was scrapping plans for a fifth and sixth nuclear-powered carrier once it finished construction of two new steam-powered vessels. To know more about that, check the video on the above card. It can be inferred that China will not be able to match the US when it comes to carrier, both in terms of quality and quantity, in the near future. So they will continue to depend on asymmetric warfare to counter American supercarriers. This includes a diverse array of anti-ship missiles, the most promising of which is the DF-21 or Dongfeng-21. The DF-21 is a two-stage, solid-fuel rocket, single-warhead, medium-range ballistic missile (MRBM) in the Dongfeng series developed by China Shengfeng Mechanics and Electronics Technology Academy. The missile is designed to be fired from land-based mobile launchers. The US Department of Defense in 2008 estimated that China had 60 to 80 missiles and 60 launchers, and approximately 10 to 11 missiles can be built annually. It's thought able to carry a high explosive and submunition warheads, as well as a nuclear warhead of 300 kilotons. The DF-21D variant is said to be the world's first anti-ship ballistic missile, ASBM. It's thought to employ a maneuverable re-entry vehicle, MARV, with a terminal guidance system. This gives it the ability to hit a moving aircraft carrier strike group from long range. According to the US National Air and Space Intelligence Center, the missile has a maximum range of around 1,450 kilometers or 900 miles. United States Naval Institute in 2009 stated that the warhead of DF-21D would be large enough to destroy an aircraft carrier in one hit, and that there was currently no defense against it if it worked as theorized. Since then, the United States has responded by deploying more SM-6 anti-ballistic missiles on its Aegis-enabled Arleigh Burke-class destroyers and Ticonderoga-class cruisers. SM-6 is a superior weapon when compared to SM-2 and SM-3 missiles, and is better equipped to intercept a missile like DF-21D. But the best way to neutralize the threat is to destroy the missiles on the ground before they can be launched. This is where Stormbreaker comes in. The Stormbreaker measures 69 inches long, 6 inches in diameter, 68 inches in wingspan, and weighs 204 pounds, or 93 kilograms. Its small size enables them to be carried in more numbers. Stormbreaker has a maneuverable airframe and deployable wings, which provide an improved standoff range. The weapon has a range of 45 miles or 72 kilometers against moving target and 69 miles or 110 kilometers for stationary targets. The impressive range and flexibility to target moving as well as stationary targets will greatly improve the lethality of ground attack missions. The Stormbreaker can use a GPS/INS system for initial guidance to move into the general vicinity of a moving target, and then use updates from UHF data link to home in on the target during the final descent. Importantly, the Seeker in Stormbreaker has three modes for diverse operational scenarios. 1. Millimeter wave radar to detect and track targets through adverse weather conditions and battlefield dust and debris. 2. Infrared imaging for enhanced target detection through the heat signature of the target. 3. A semi-active laser that enables it to track an airborne or ground target that's illuminated with a laser designator. Information is shared seamlessly among all three modes for accurate targeting. Demonstration of the multi-mode Seeker's capability was done during a series of captive flight tests completed in December 2011. Stormbreaker carries a 105-pound or 48-kilogram warhead. The shaped charge plasma jet technology multifunctional warhead in the bomb has both blast and fragmentation effects. This means that the bomb can be effective against not only unhardened structures, infantry vehicles, but also against heavily armored main battle tanks. The fuse of the warhead can be configured to trigger on impact or at a preset height above the intended target or in a delayed mode. The warhead's capability was first demonstrated during a series of tests in November 2011. The Nimitz and upcoming Ford-class supercarrier's main offensive force consists of the FA-18 Hornet and FA-18 Super Hornet. Each can carry around 60 of these and will be the trump card when it comes to enforcing air dominance. These are twin-engine, supersonic, all-weather carrier-capable, fourth-generation multi-role fighter aircraft and can carry ground attack weapons as well as air-to-air missiles. The versatility of the aircraft can be gauged from the fact that on the first day of Operation Desert Storm, two FA-18 Hornets, each carrying four 2,000-pound bombs, shot down two Iraqi MiGs and then proceeded to deliver their bombs on target. Going forward, the supercarriers will also be operationally deploying F-35C, which is a variant of F-35 meant specifically for the carrier-based operation. The most important aspect of F-35C is its ability to bring stealth attack capability to American supercarrier. China is still a long way from deploying a proper fifth-generation stealthy fighter, let alone having any carrier-based variant. F-35Cs, with its stealth profile and 1,200 nautical miles or 2,200-kilometer range, can penetrate high-threat airspace from long ranges, enabling the aircraft carriers to operate from a safe distance. Stormbreaker will be extremely handy when it comes to upgrading the air-to-ground capability of FA-18 Hornet, FA-18 Super Hornet, and F-35C Lightning II. American supremacy in aircraft carrier, both in terms of quality and quantity, means it has a very strong and flexible deployable force. Powered by nuclear energy, these have unlimited range, giving them the ability to be deployed everywhere from anywhere. Stormbreaker is designed to enhance the offensive capability of the air wing when it comes to taking out mobile or stationary ground targets. Since it's small, the fighters can carry it in more quantity as compared to other bombs. This means that fewer aircraft can take out more targets. This will also enable the U.S. Navy fighters to saturate the Chinese air defenses through a coordinated air raid. Importantly, Since Stormbreaker will be inside the weapons bay and not hooked externally, F-35C will be able to retain its stealthy profile. This will give the US Navy a significant advantage.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.